Very good evening, everyone. My name is Shubham Singhania, and I'm your mentor for UGC NET Paper 1, Paper 2, Commerce and Management. So a lot of students have been asking me, sir, please bring in some IIM PhD candidate on the channel so that we can have a sneak peek into the life of a PhD scholar at IIMs. So taking into your request into consideration, today I have a very, very special guest. I have Ms. Prachi Jain, who is pursuing her PhD in the area of finance from IIM Indore. That is one of the most prestigious colleges and institute in the area of management. So, aaj hum inse baatein karenge and pata karenge that how did she landed up to IIM Indore and what does she does in throughout her day, kya kya karti hai ye, how is her life and how is her daily routine. So, welcome Prachi. I am sure that all the students, all the viewers who are going to listen to you today are going to be highly inspired aur unko kaafi sara inspiration milne wala hai ki kis tarike se unko PhD ke liye prepare karna chahiye. So, welcome to our channel once again.
Thank you so much, bhaiya. I'll try कि आपकी hopes में fulfill कर पाऊँ.
Okay. So Prachi, that brings me to the first question. Can you throw some light on what has been your educational background? What has been your educational qualification?
Sir, I did my bachelor's in commerce from Indraprastha College of Women, Delhi University. Then I did my master's in commerce with a specialization in finance from Delhi School of Economics, Department of Commerce. And now I'm here in my third year of PhD at IIM Indore. Mm-hmm. And I think that with the limited exposure that I had, I totally defy the conventional belief ki PhD karne ke liye aapko bahut elaborate, of course, elaborate profile ho to wo better rehta hai. But aise nahi hai ki you can't just streamline everything and sequentially move into a PhD program. You certainly can.
Right. So I think maine bilkul sahi shuruaat kari thi. Like I said, that you're going to be a lot of inspiration for a lot of people and a lot of future aspirants who are planning to get into PhD, because that is a common convention ki aapka profile bahut acha hona chahiye, bahut top institute se hone chahiye if you have to get into premium institute. So I'm sure that you are breaking and bursting out that myth today.
Thank you.
Okay. Prachi, that brings me to the next question, that when did you actually plan and decide that you want to get into academia and research, and how did you start with your preparation?
Again, अनकन्वेंशनल टू द नॉर्मल बिलीफ कि आपको अंदर से रिसर्च आता है. मेरे साथ ऐसा कुछ कभी कुछ नहीं हुआ. आई जस्ट न्यू फ्रॉम अ वेरी अर्ली एज दैट आई वांटेड टू टीच, दैट आई वांटेड टू बी अ प्रोफेसर. सो मोर देन अ कॉन्शियस डिसीजन, दिस वाज एन ऑब्लिगेटरी माइलस्टोन फॉर मी दैट यू हैव टू हैव अ पीएचडी डिग्री टू बी अ प्रोफेसर एट अ प्रीमियर इंस्टीट्यूशन और टू वर्क इट अहेड. सो आई नेवर हैड टू रियली decide and choose where else to go. I just knew that this is the path for me to follow.
Wonderful. And when did you actually start your preparation, Prachi? What time duration?
For a PhD admission.
Yes, yes.
I think a very thorough coursework with BCom and MCom was what my most of PhD preparation would be accumulated into. Kyunki PhD ke liye specifically aap kitna bhi chaho, it is so vast. You cannot just wake up one day and want to prepare. It's you have to be very thorough with your coursework in bachelor's and master's to know what you're actually entering into. Right. So, वैसे सिर्फ written exam के हिसाब से 3 months पहले शुरू कर दिया था, because written exam में जब मेरे time पे written exam होता था IIM Indore में, तो उस time पे econometrics आना जरूरी होता था apart from the coursework. तो इकोनोमेट्रिक्स में वो बेसिक रिसर्च मेथड्स एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स वाज इंपॉर्टेंट एंड प्रोबेबिलिटी वाज इंपॉर्टेंट. सो ऑल ऑफ दीस थिंग्स दैट आई हैड टू ब्रश अप, आई स्टार्टेड डूइंग दैट 3 months बिफोर हैविंग अप्लाइड हियर. सो आई स्टार्टेड ऑल ऑफ दिस नियर अबाउट माय लास्ट सेमेस्टर ऑफ एमकॉम.
राइट, वंडरफुल. सो आई थिंक बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट चीज प्राची हैज ऑलरेडी मेंशन की ऐसा नहीं है कि सिर्फ 3 महीने 6 महीने पहले पढ़ाई कर लो एंड यू गेट इनटू अ प्रीमियम इंस्टीट्यूट. आई थिंक 3 साल ग्रेजुएशन, 2 साल पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन और उस पूरे 5 साल के टाइम ड्यूरेशन में योर लेवल ऑफ नॉलेज, योर लेवल ऑफ कंसेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी एक्चुअली टेक्स यू टू सच प्रीमियर इंस्टीट्यूट्स लाइक IIMs. ओके प्राची, देन दैट ब्रिंग्स मी टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट हाउ डिड यू एक्चुअली चोज योर एरिया, बिकॉज वो एक बहुत बड़ा कंफ्यूजन रहता है स्टूडेंट्स के दिमाग में कि फाइनेंस ले, मार्केटिंग ले, एंड हाउ डिड यू स्केल योर टॉपिक फाइनली इन योर ओन एरिया.
Sir, I chose finance during my MCom in my second year as a specialization, and that was because the finance professor over there, Ms. Abha Shukla, she is quite a celebrity. So everyone would, of course, recommend you to go for finance. Mm-hmm. And she is superb at her job. She, there's no one who hasn't fallen in love with finance if she has taught you.
Right.
So she made me realize that this is my calling. So area was never such a task for me to decide because specialization in finance to usi tarah se wo jata raha. Lekin topic decide karna was a very tedious task.
Right.
But with IIMs, again, it becomes easier for you because for 1.5 years, you're exposed to that coursework. So I sat through several courses in finance. I sat through corporate governance, behavioral finance. I sat through commodities, banking, asset pricing, and several other courses in a similar fashion. So once you're exposed to literature of all of these courses, you know what you connect with more. At least something would strike you someday or the other. Right. So of course I had my own ideas, I had my own notions, but ये तो सबसे ज़्यादा utopian रास्ता होता है, एक और रास्ता होता है जो शायद कम share किया जाता है, वो ही होता है कि आपको शायद topic से calling ना आए, आपको अपने supervisor से calling आ जाए.
Right.
So I took a course with a professor and I knew that I really wanted to work with him. So I right now for my thesis would be working on a question that has been given to me by him.
I think Prachi, that is also a very right move because with a professor who is an experienced professor, who is an expert in a particular field, if you're working for a period of 4-5 years, so I think ki unki jo knowledge hai, unki jo skills hai, I'm sure that is going to trickle down to their scholars. So I think wo ultimately long run mein benefit karega.
Hey, so benefit to dono cheezon pe rehta hai. Aise bhi hai ki if it's your own research question, then you're definitely more motivated.
Right.
Then it keeps you driving because it's your problem, you are finding the solution to that problem. So a lot of people also face this problem that when they're working on a problem given to them by someone else, they lose interest in the problem, they don't want to pursue it. So far it's been good for me, but of course it might have a con later on, but I'm really enjoying, you know, experiencing different methods and learning new techniques and softwares. So right now I'm working on this spillover mechanism jisme systemic risk dekhte hain, to usme uska pura code karna, then usko jaise mein run karna, I think that's quite an exposure for me and I'm enjoying it so far.
So I think till the time you're enjoying it, whether you have chosen the topic by yourself or it has been assigned by the supervisor, I don't think it anyways makes any difference.
Right.
Prachi, now that brings me to the next question. Since we know that if you're applying to IIMs, we have to provide a statement of purpose. So how did you prepare for your statement of purpose, or what are the specific elements that you included in statement of purpose?
A statement of purpose essentially has to have 4 elements, which I of course talked to my seniors about to learn about it. Because jab aap due mechanism mein hota hai, aapko statement of purpose likhne ki kabhi bhi naubat hi nahi aati hai.
Right.
So jo 4 elements mujhe bataye gaye the, they were like the first portion of your SOP should talk about your own self. Why do you want to, who are you, what have you done in the past? Then the second part of it talks about why would you want to be a PhD holder. The third part talks about why this area, this specific area that you're applying for, why would that be your calling? And the last is that why would you want to, do you have a problem in mind?
Right.
So if this is the area, then what would it actually, what would you want to work on?
Right. So I think Prachi, you have rightly put up all the 4 areas. I think it's kind of the institution, why that particular institute is important, that can also be added on.
Exactly that one.
Right. Now Prachi, that brings me to the next question. Since hamare dimag mein ek what do you say, there's a hype going around that when you apply for IIMs, aapko interview ke liye ek alag hi level ki taiyari karni padti hai. So what is your take on this? What are the specific elements that you feel have to be prepared if you're applying to premier institutes like IIMs?
एक तो बहुत ही golden rule of interview होता है that in an interview you have to impress. So you have to, of course, answer their questions, but you have to also answer them pleasantly. So I'll tell you this, Bia, I appeared for IIM Indore's interview, of course, but I also sat for IIT Delhi's interview. And there I failed miserably. Like I could actually feel the embarrassment even after leaving that space of interview because I failed to impress there. So IIT Delhi gave me about 2-2.5 minutes to have a conversation with them, but I just could not put the best of myself out there. So with interview, again, as I mentioned, I've been asked about everything in finance. Some of the basic questions also, I was asked, what is the agency problem, for example. All of these problems, you know, they still can be tackled. You can go around with whatever little you know. But the hurdle comes in where, you know, they give you a statistics question to solve right there with a paper and a pen that, okay, solve it for us and show us step-wise. And then the adrenaline rush there and you forget all the math that you've ever done. Yes. So I think practicing that was very important for me when I sat for my IIM Indore interview. I was asked a question about probability. I was asked, there was this very simple question that they asked me to understand if I know anything at all about research. So they asked me that, how would you identify your research problem?
Right.
So I told them, I was very naive, I was a complete amateur. So I told them that just, you know, see what has been done in the past and then find a problem. So they just wanted to know that whether I know that looking into the past and looking into the background is called literature review or not.
Right.
So they just wanted to hear the word literature review from my mouth, that has she ever read a research paper or not. So I think a little bit of acquaintance to the domain that you're entering in, because for me, I took about 6 months to even to be able to read a full research paper, because the writing style is so different. The content is heavy. I used to skip the methodology part for good period of time.
Yes.
So, had I begun early, I would have been better at it and I would have saved some time over here. So that's another suggestion, that at least be acquainted to the literature or to how to read a paper for the bare minimum.
Right. I think we all learn through our own ups and downs and through our own journey, and I'm sure that it's going beautifully with you, Prachi. Okay, Prachi, that brings me to the next question now, that what are the specific elements that should be considered by an individual before joining PhD at any institute? Kuch factors hai jo dhyan mein rakhne chahiye, what do you think?
Very honestly, apply to sab taraf hi karna chahiye. Don't be shortlisting institutes while applying, but once you get a call from several institutes and then you have to make your pick. I think the easiest way to go about is to look at their faculty curriculum duties. So for all institutions, you will have faculty section on their website, and all of the curriculum duties are publicly available to the best of my knowledge. So what you have to look for in their resume is that, when was their last publication, how active is the research department over that in that institute, and how diverse is the profile of the, if you're not sure about where you want to go, then you have to look at the diversity of the profile of permanent faculty over there. And if you know what you want to work in, then you have to look at profiles of professors who have matching interest as yours. Probably shortlisting a professor that you'd want to impress from the beginning once you join the institute would be a good strategy to go about.
Yes, Prachi, I think that had I known these things 3 years back or 3 or 4 years back, I think bahut achhe decisions students le pate. But probably all of these things that were happening right now in terms of interview and then looking into how is the journey of a PhD students is going to glimpse to a lot of future aspirants, that what PhD is gonna be, what it is going to be all about. So I think thank you for sharing some really beautiful insights jo otherwise hame nahi pata chalte. Now Prachi, that brings me to the next question, ki students ke dimag mein ek bahut common sa doubt hai, that हमें टीचिंग में इंटरेस्ट है बट रिसर्च में नहीं है, ठीक है? So what should be the suggestion or what should be the way out for these kind of a candidate? How should they go about it?
पहली चीज तो इसमें मैं ये कहना चाहूंगी that before we make a remark की रिसर्च में इंटरेस्ट नहीं है, be sure that you have been exposed to research. क्योंकि अगर 2.5 साल पहले had we been having this conversation, even I would have said that I know I want to teach, but research, I don't think I want to research. So once you start researching, it's almost impossible to dislike research. Research is, it's this energy booster. You wake up to a problem every day and you want to just solve. It's your own problem. So there's something that's driving you. Then, you know, this common attribute with everyone who wants to teach. So their basic attribute is that they're inquisitive. And how can an inquisitive person not like research? Absolutely. So the first comment that I have about it is that maybe you have not identified the right problem. Give it another shot. Maybe you just really like research. And the second sad news that I'll like to give them is that if research is a complete no for you, then you might have to settle for something not as good.
Right.
It's, I don't think that I'm correct in saying that not as good. What I want to say is that when you are applying for a premier institute, research is an imperative. You have to have, it's in fact a race. You have to publish as many papers as you can, as fast as you can. So if it's really not the case for you, then probably, and you're very sure that teaching is the only thing, is the only way for you, maybe go for your own personal establishment where you are like a coaching institute, a self-driven establishment. Second is that you can apply for institutes that do not need a lot of publications. So, you know, the, for example, Delhi University, I know about NMIMS. So since NMIMS is a new budding institute, so the researchers there are also budding, and they don't have that kind of a pressure building upon them to publish every day. So one, of course, you will have to have a PhD degree with the new mandate. You have to have a PhD degree to even progress to a higher level of like level 2 or level 1. Beyond ADDOC, there's nothing without a PhD degree. So probably get your PhD and then enroll into some of these institutes where you don't have to publish much and you can focus on teaching as your main priority.
I think that's a very wonderful suggestion, because बहुत सारे लोग हैं जिनको रिसर्च नहीं करनी होती, तो प्रोबेबली दे कैन लुक फॉर द पब्लिकेशन क्राइटेरिया रिक्वायर्ड एट अ पर्टिकुलर इंस्टीट्यूट, लाइक यू मेंशन अबाउट दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी एंड ऑल अदर्स, तो वहां पे अप्लाई कर दीजिए, वहां से पीएचडी कंप्लीट कर लीजिए, एंड देन यू कैन स्पेसिफिकली फोकस ऑन टीचिंग. राइट प्राची, नाउ दैट ब्रिंग्स मी टू द लास्ट फॉर्मल क्वेश्चन, एंड दैट इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी योर इनपुट्स और व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी योर एडवाइसेस टू ऑल द फ्यूचर एस्पिरेंट्स हु आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई टू प्रीमियर इंस्टीट्यूट्स लाइक आईआईएम्स.
For future aspirants who are already trying to apply for an IIM but haven't been able to bag a role, I'll say for the time that you have in your hands right now, be thorough with softwares, be thorough. If I'm talking about my area personally, because I am in finance and it's more a quantitatively oriented area. So softwares like RStudio, Stata, Python, I think they're very important, and it takes a huge amount of time to even have a hands-on experience with them. So probably just use this time that you're not being able to bag a role in an institution to have a hands-on experience with these. Second is that writing mails helps a lot. So one should write a lot of mails. If you come across a paper, you like that author, just write an appreciative mail to that person that I liked your paper. I have this and this doubt. How do you go about it? And again, this one thing that I don't think is known much, even I did not know about it, that to actually collaborate with a professor, you don't have to be a PhD student elsewhere. You can just be an ordinary student. You can write a mail. If your interest matches with that person, he'd want to work with you, and you can have publication without having a PhD also. Once you appear for a PhD and you have a publication on your profile, there's a very hard chance, like you really have to ruin your interview for them to not take you in the institution. So of course, writing mails would help you have that network where you can feel that comfort of approaching someone to be able to work with them.
Prachi, I think I don't need to add anything. You have rightly put up all the wonderful points, and certainly these points are going to be really, really helpful to all the future aspirants. Now, without allowing you to leave, I just want to have one bouncer question with you. Can you just give us a brief glimpse of how is your daily routine? What do you do in a daily life? Is it a very boring kind of a life, or do you relax and chill also during your PhD journey?
My life is tough food. It's good. I have friends here. I think that's very important. एक बहुत अडेज रहता है कि पीएचडी इज़ अ लोनली जर्नी. वो लोनली होती है. वो लोनली इसलिए होती है कि आपके पास एक रिसर्च प्रॉब्लम है, उस पर आप काम करो. अगर आप उसमें इफ यू आर स्टक समवेयर, देन इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड हेल्प. आप उनको पूरा रिसर्च प्रॉब्लम समझाओगे, आप उनको डेटा का फॉर्मेट समझाओगे, आप उनको कोड का फॉर्मेट समझाओगे. इतना टाइम किसके पास है ना. तो योर प्रॉब्लम इज योर प्रॉब्लम. यू इट्स अ चैलेंज फॉर योर ओन सेल्फ. तो आई थिंक जब भी ये कहा जाता है पीएचडी इज अ लोनली जर्नी, वो उस चीज में होता है कि वो रिस्क सिस्टमैटिक रिस्क नहीं है. जैसे एम कॉम में, बी कॉम में एक बच्चे को अगर प्रॉब्लम हुई है तो द एंटायर क्लास इज देयर टू हेल्प दैट पर्सन.
एंड यू कैन कॉपी आल्सो यूजिंग देयर नोट्स.
Yes, and you are supposed to be their mentor. You are not supposed to say that.
Yes.
So, but I have friends here, and friends have to keep saying, because aapke supervisor bhi kabhi kabhi, you know, they're very nice otherwise, but they might not like you someday, and they might want to scream at you someday, and then you want to offload that burden onto someone. Right. As for my daily routine, I wake up early. I am early. And I wake up. I'm an early riser. Then I'd like to go for a walk, a jog, or recently I started playing squash here in Iron and all. Then breakfast, then I study. So if you know, a lot of people think ki PhD itni padhai kyun karni hai. After a while, it's not even padhai, it's work. You're literally working on Excel all day. So aap kya padhai kar rahe ho? Uske baad to matlab it's just literature, it's your work.
Right.
It's not ki aap जो पढ़ाई सोचते हैं ना हम कि एमकॉम में जैसे हम वनीता त्रिपाठी मैम की बुक पढ़ते थे, वो वाली पढ़ाई नहीं है. इट्स अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ जॉनर, कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट है. तो देन आई स्टडी फॉर अ फ्यू आवर्स. मतलब बहुत फ्लेक्सिबल रहता है, जैसे जब मन करता है उस हिसाब से थोड़ी देर पढ़ लेती हूँ. फिर इफ माई फ्रेंड्स आर सिटिंग आउटसाइड, देन आई चिल विद देम, देन आई कम बैक, आई स्टडी. I think that's the best part about it, कि ऐसे working hours नहीं है, it's a project, independent project.
Very flexible.
आप अपने, हाँ, आप अपने हिसाब से just go about.
Right.
But be timely, and it's very important to be consistent, because God, if you lose grip once, it's very difficult to get that back.
Right.
और during the journey, I think it's very important to remember and realize कि हाँ पे हमेशा के लिए नहीं रहना.
Right.
The earlier you finish, the better it will be for you.
Right.
तो बहुत सारे लोग यहाँ पे ऐसे भूल जाते हैं कि because they enjoy it so much, अपना चल रहा है काम. I really think that this approach might be problematic for a lot of us, especially for girls, right?
Right. So Prachi, I think it was a beautiful having you here and having beautiful conversation, taking a sneak peek into the journey of a PhD scholar at IIM Indore, जो कि generally नहीं पता चलता है. So thank you so much once again for finding time and coming out on this channel and talking to me and telling our students that how should they prepare and how should they also chill or chillax at IIM Indore. So thank you once again.
Thank you so much, Bhaiya, for giving me this opportunity. And I'm sorry for how many times I've called you, Bhaiya. And I, of course, thank you for giving me the comfort of being able to talk to you so openly about it.
Okay, most welcome.
Yeah. And I really hope that this could help others. I don't think... even if it's 1% value addition, it'll be great.
It is surely a wonderful value addition, Prachi. Thank you once again.
Okay, Bhaiya. Thank you so much.